If you've had any sort of electrical issue on a car before, you've probably known or have been told to check the fuse. No matter how advanced your automotive electrical knowledge may be, the fuse is always a good place to start. This video is going to explain why that is, why we have fuses in the first place, how they work, where they go, and you may even learn some things about electricity along the way. So I'll start by explaining what it is you're looking at. We have a 12-volt battery that's common in many cars, we have a fuse, and we have a load. In this case, the load is a headlight bulb. The lines I've drawn here are basically the wires. You have a wire coming out of the positive post, it goes through the fuse to this light bulb, and then it comes back to the negative post. You have no way of switching it on and off, so you'd have a switch in there, but I've left that out just to keep this as simple as possible. Components that do stuff in your circuit tend to have a resistance rating, which is measured in ohms. Again, to keep this circuit super simple for this example, I've given it a really easy number to work with, which is 1 ohm. Using math that we'll get into in a completely different video, this circuit is 12 amps. So is this 12 amp circuit going to blow this fuse? We'll look at the top of this fuse and we'll see that it says 20A for 20 amps. So this fuse is rated to work up to 20 amps. Now, let's say we put the wrong kind of bulb in this circuit. This bulb is supposed to be a 1 ohm resistance bulb, and we ended up putting in a 0.5 resistance bulb. When resistance goes down, amperage goes up. In fact, since the resistance is half of what it was before, the amperage is going to be double what it was before. So we went from 12 amps to 24 amps. 24 is more amperage than this 20 amp fuse can handle, so this fuse just blew, and our circuit is incomplete now. We don't get power going through this area to the bulb, and the bulb does not light up. Now, with this understanding of how many amps are flowing through the circuit, you may be tempted to go, okay, I get it, this 20 amp fuse is not going to be able to handle that. Let's replace it with a 30 amp fuse. You do not want to do that. This fuse is here to protect everything on the circuit, not just to prevent you from putting your fancy headlight bulbs in. When an engineer designed the circuit, they did the math on what this bulb is going to run amperage-wise, and they selected wire specifically for that circuit. If they designed all the components to handle way more amperage than they were ever going to experience in normal situations, the car would be a lot more heavy and a lot more expensive. With this 20 amp fuse selected, they probably picked a wire that can flow 21 or 22 amps. Same goes for the switch or relay that they selected for that circuit, and same with the socket that this bulb plugs into. If you want to change this part out and make the circuit a different amperage, you're going to have to upgrade everything along the path. If you accidentally started running 24 amps on this circuit like we were describing earlier, this fuse would blow out. If you were to use a 30 amp fuse instead, something else on this circuit is going to burn up instead. When it comes to replacing parts in a circuit, typically the fuse is both the easiest to get to and the least expensive. Now let's get into why the fuse is located where it is. Let's switch these components around. In a series circuit like this one, amperage is the same the entire path. Amperage does not blow out components in the order that it reaches them. So technically, this layout would work. However, we are going to keep the fuse here for a reason. On pretty much every car, the entire body is a ground, or let's call it negative for simplicity's sake. So it's connected to the negative on this battery. If this wire breaks and then suddenly falls down and touches the body, you have a short. There's nothing from positive to negative that's going to consume that power, so amperage spikes up dramatically because there's pretty much no resistance on this circuit. That amperage is going to create a lot of heat, and that heat is going to affect the weak points of the circuit first, and that weak point on this particular layout is in the center of this fuse. So we're going to pull this fuse out. Before we put a new fuse in, we have to fix this wire. We've spliced in a new wire, and now we can put in a new fuse and make sure it's always the same amperage. So what would happen if that same scenario that happened here instead? Well, the power would flow through here, and then you'd have a wire meltdown, and then you'd probably have to replace this section of wire, and you might have some body area that's melted, and you have to fix that too. But that's really unlikely, because this wire is coming off the battery and going to the fuse box. The wire leading from the battery to the fuse box shouldn't encounter a whole lot of movement or potential for damage, so that scenario is unlikely, but it is possible. Still, with that in mind, the closer you can get your fuse to this positive post, the less unprotected circuit you end up with. So for safety's sake, let's relocate this fuse right here. From here to here is protected now when it wasn't before. So if you're working on your car and discover that there's a blown fuse, don't just pull it out and stick a new one in. And definitely, definitely do not try to replace that fuse with one with a higher amperage so you don't blow it. That fuse melted down so something else on the circuit didn't. You or your mechanic are gonna have to figure out what component was causing the issue and repair or replace it. If you learned something or enjoyed the way that I presented this, give this video a like. If you feel like I missed some important details, let me know in the comments below. Either way, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next Car Simplified video.